Good evening, everyone. Myself, Ashu Sharma. I welcome you all in series of Network Topology. So today we will discuss brief introduction of topology. आज जो डिस्कशन का विषय है वो नेटवर्क टोपोलॉजी है। तो इसमें हम सबसे पहले बात करेंगे टोपोलॉजी होता क्या है। टोपोलॉजी इज बेसिकली अ लेआउट व्हेन वी कंसीडर द डिजाइन ऑफ कंप्यूटर कनेक्शन विद पेरिफेरल डिवाइसेस। सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एज वी ऑल नो दैट टोपोलॉजी इट्स सिंपली अ दैट डिजाइन इज गोइंग टू बी इम्प्लीमेंट टू कनेक्ट डिफरेंट पेरिफेरल्स विद दैट कंप्यूटर सिस्टम्स। So here the significance of topology is important. Isme sabse pehle design efficient protocols. Protocols are the rules and the regulations that we use for the communication purpose. It solves the internet working problems like routing, resource reservation, and administration. So it's very important to find out the perfect route of sending the data frames from one node computer to another node computer. Same along with that, create accurate model for simulation. It writes the estimates for topological parameters and study fault tolerance so that network will remain in sustain if suppose there is an error happens or technical fault happens, and also the study of anti-attack properties. So this is the significance that we may say that topology is important. Now come to the next slide, that topology is basically of a network. It defines how the nodes of a network are connected. So there are different nodes in a network, and how these nodes are connected, which is important when we consider topology. Basically, there are two basic categories of network topology. Once we talk about the network, first one is a physical topology, and the second one is a logical topology. So physical topology is something which is having that wired connection between the computers and the peripherals. So defines how the nodes of the network are physically connected. And when we talk about the logical topology, how data is transmitted between the nodes and dedicated connections between certain and selected source to destination pairs using the underlying physical topology. So in order to have an efficient system, the logical topology should be chosen such that either the average hop distance or the packet delay or the maximum flow or any link must be minimal. So basically, physical topology is dedicated as a wired connection among the systems, and logical topology is something in which we are looking for data transmission, and it is not necessary that there is a wired connection. So this is basically two broad categories of networks. Now come to the next slide. Here we have the shape of cabling layout used to link devices called the physical topology of the network, as I said to you before, and this refers to the layout of cabling and the location of nodes and the interconnections between the nodes and the cabling. Second is the physical topology of a network is determined by a capability of the network and the access devices and media, the level of control or fault tolerance desired, and the cost associated with the cabling or telecommunication circuits. Now, next is the logical topology. In contrast, is the way that the signals acts on a network media, or the way that the data passes through the network from one device to the next without regard of the physical interconnection of the devices. So a network logical topology is not necessarily the same as its physical topology. These are two broad categories. Now when we talk about the physical topology on the basis of the shapes of network, we have that mesh, star, bus, ring, tree, and hybrid. So as we all know that these are based on shape base. Now the first one in this series is the mesh topology, which is a wonderful topology when we talk about the security point of view, when we talk about that the fault tolerance point of view. A network setup where each computer and network device is interconnected with one another, allowing for most transmission to be distributed even if one of the connections go down. So fault tolerance is wonderfully that just tackled. This topology is not commonly used for most computer networks, as it is difficult and expensive to have the redundant connection to every computer. So as you know that if suppose there are n number of computers, then there should be n minus one interlink that is attached to single computer. So total number of interconnection links will be n into n minus one. So that's why we say it's expensive and difficult to deploy, but in terms of the security point of view and accuracy point of view, And in terms of a fault tolerance concept, it is wonderful topology to be have. And this topology is commonly used for wireless networks. And below is a visual example that we have in this given figure of a mesh topology. Suppose here we have these total number of system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So connection of one system, interconnection links are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if for one system there are total 5 interconnection links, so for 6 it will be 5 by 6, it equals to 30. So this is the way that this mesh topology just you structure out. And there are specific advantages also. They use dedicated links, so each link can only carry its own data load, so traffic problem can be avoided. It is robust, so if any one link gets damaged, it cannot affect others as well. It gives privacy and security. Masses travel, you can say it's a traversal along the dedicated link, and fault identification and isolation are easy, so in the mesh topology. Now, if there are certain pros, there are certain cons as well. Disadvantages, the amount of cabling cost should increase, and the number of IO ports required are very large. It will be N minus one if suppose there are N systems. Since every device is connected to each devices through dedicated links, the sheer bulk of wiring is larger, so sometimes it's a physical space problem, and the hardware required to connect each device is highly expensive. Now here we have some applications of mesh topology. Here we have telephone, regional office, and wide area network, which is generally used internet. Now in this series, the next one is the star topology. Star topology is generally used the hub and the switch as a central device, which is the controller. So here we have this, here each device has a dedicated point-to-point link to the central controller called hub, acts as exchange. There is no direct traffic between the devices. The transmission are occurred only through the central hub. And when we talk about, there are two categories. One is passive, other is active. Passive hub simply connects the arms of a star. No signal regeneration is performed in, when we talk about that active hub, except that it regenerates the signals. The next category is intelligent hubs. And not only regenerates the signal, but also performs the activities such as intelligent path selection and network management. So these are three different categories. In hub, it generally broadcasts, once you talk about it, broadcasts the data frames to all the systems. So there are certain ports, it never looking for that MAC address of a system, or it never looking for some of the internet protocol address. It simply just transfer the data to all the system in a broadcast way. So this is one of these limitation. So once we talk about the advantages, it's less expensive than mesh if you consider it, since each device is connected only to the hub. Installation and configuration are easy. Less cabling is needed than mesh, and robustness, if one link fails, only that link is affected, all other links remain active. Easy to fault identification to remove parts. But if suppose the central controlling device like hub is going to be failed, then entire network will be collapsed. Even it requires less cabling, as we know, in comparison with the mesh, then mesh, when compared with other topologies, it's still large, that frame or worse. Dependency, whole dependent on the one single point hub, then it goes down, the whole system is dead. So these are the disadvantages. Now, certain applications that belongs to star topology, we have used in local area networks, LANs, and high speed LAN often use star. So this is till now for this lecture. Thank you very much being with me in this session. If you like these videos, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so you may get the notification of the latest uploaded video. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.